Stevie's a very beautiful man. He's a very good lyricist. He's a beat poet, really.
You're talking about somebody who is a really genuine, modest guy.
His poetry is exceptional.
I can call on him anytime I need a little bit of inspiration.
He knows so many people, and he nurtures and cares for all of those friendships. I'm amazed how he does it.
I just felt this presence of this most beautiful human.
He's just great. I love him to bits. He's top.
Polemics, poetry, and peace. Observations left unspoken of what life means and the nature of existence.
Stephen Kalinich, poet and lyricist, has been one of the most adored men by both his industry peers and the world's pop and rock loving public since the 60s. The writer and collaborator on many songs for the Beach Boys, including Be Still and Little Bird. He was born in Endicott, New York, and moved to Brentwood, California, where he began working the LA scene as a poet and performer, and where he ultimately came to prominence with Brian and Dennis Wilson. During the course of his long career, he has written songs for a range of high-profile artists, but in recent years, visiting Brighton has provided fresh inspiration.
In Brighton, I found the poet could shine. The poet was not judged. The poet could express himself. Could do things with video, with screens. For me, in America, to launch things has been much more difficult as a poet. In the 60s, it was a little easier, but it never quite, I felt I got an extra push in England of acceptance. I just think the English people in general were open to a lot of areas that weren't just, you know, gonna be a hit, but were stimulating, were thoughtful, were touching.
In the course of his visits, Stevie has met many local musicians.
I first met Stevie probably about 6 or 7 years ago. Now he was over in Brighton, I think just to visit some friends and make some new contacts.
And I ended up doing a club date. It's called The Greys in Brighton.
As I'm in a band called the Brighton Beach Boys, a few of us were asked down to come and join him on some numbers and to do some of our Beach Boys tunes.
He came into a Brighton Beach Boys rehearsal and was introduced to us all as the lyricist of Little Bird and Be Still, two songs from the Beach Boys' Friends album.
They were huge Beach Boy fans. They know every Beach Boys song, probably better than the Beach Boys.
I said to Stevie, you know, what are you doing at the weekend? Because we've got a gig with the full band. It'd be lovely if you came along. We took him along to the Herne Bay Festival, it was, in Kent. Completely new territory for him, I think, and he met the rest of the band.
Just as we were about to go on stage, he handed me his phone and said, Ralph, I've got a call for you, and it was Brian Wilson.
He spoke to about three or four of us, had pretty much the same conversation with all of us.
Hey, how are you doing? I said, well, Brian, we're just about to go on stage, play all of your songs. So he said, well, make sure you play California Girls.
By the time we actually hit the stage, I think the word had spread around through the crew and the sound guys. And so I think the audience basically knew that we'd been on the phone to LA. And we got a massive reception, and Stevie came and joined us on the stage. The headline writ large of the Herne Bay Festival was Beach Boy Phones Bay. So I think we did good work for all of us there. You know, the South Coast here and the West Coast in the States as well went down very well.
I first met Stevie in my house, actually, when he had come to Brighton. And Ralph had been talking about this guy for ages. Every day he would come home and say, oh, I met the most beautiful man on the planet. His name is Stevie Kalinich. You've got to meet him. And I remember he was working in London or something, and I kept not being able to meet him, you know, to go out and see him. And Stevie came round, and he recited one of his poems. He recited The Magic Hand. And I remember just sitting there next to Ralph, and I started crying. I just thought, this is a spoken word artist, you know, of kind of extraordinary talent, and it's one of the most emotional people I've ever met.
he's a fantastic performer of his work. He's a real, he really is the genuine article as a 60s poet, and he brings his work to people with such passion and conviction.
Stevie has staged a number of shows locally, and he performed two shows during the 2008 Brighton Festival.
I did a radio show in England with David Courtney. He had a radio show, and at that show, another guest was Richard Durrant, who was a classical guitar player and played with the group Sky in the United Kingdom. And in 2008, Richard and I ended up putting together the Galactic Symphonies, and we played it in the Brighton Fringe Festival.
I saw Stevie perform during the Brighton Festival. He was just beautiful. And I always find it really moving. I always feel really, really open and emotional.
We played here, actually, in the latest music bar last time he was in Brighton. We did some improvisation with him there, and it was great. He was all dressed in white, and he looked like some kind of, like, messiah. We played all those songs, those fantastic songs that he'd written the words for, stuff that he'd done for Randy Crawford, and Diana Ross, and Brian Wilson, and Dennis Wilson.
He's written music for so many people, and so many people think, really, so many superstars think highly of him, that I think he deserves a good reception next time he comes over.
From these live collaborations came the premise for Stevie's album, California Feeling, after one chance conversation with Charlotte Glasson.
Charlotte Glasson, who has played with Oasis and many other groups, in Brighton, England, on the beach one day, sitting on the rocks, she said, instead of doing poetry with music, why don't you just do some of your journals?
When I'm working with him, I kind of almost just want to leave him center stage and with all the limelight and just put things in behind him just to emphasize things very subtly and not distract from it, what he's got to say really, but to enhance it, I suppose, and make it even more powerful.
And it was very exciting. I've done poems and songs, but I did this journal entry, poetic journal entry, and she put music to it, and that was the piece from Brentwood to Brighton, from Brighton to Brentwood, because I spent so many months performing in Brighton in the fringe festivals, and I grew to love the city as my second home for 3 or 4 years in a row.
Brentwood is a place in LA where Stevie grew up. And then, obviously, he found himself in Brighton. And it's kind of like a mini biography, I suppose.
He's caught somewhere between Brentwood and Brighton on the road, and he does not know where he's going, but he hopes that he will get there, and he can't find the answer, and he can't solve the riddle. And he walks along the coast, and he goes down back to Cornwall, and he sees the beautiful water, and he wants to jump into the unknown, off the cliffs into the sea.
Between Brentwood and Brighton became the catalyst for California Feeling, an album which features a number of native Brightonians contributing performances and arrangements.
I wanted to use these musicians if I ever was fortunate enough to get a deal where I could use them. And they are all incredible musicians and wonderful people. The idea behind the California Feeling album was to take some of my poems and my songs by different people, especially my songs with the Beach Boys, and have different artists express their versions of those songs and put in some new material.
The only place I could pretend that I was popular or smart before I knew of books or art.
Steve Wrigley and Glenn Richardson did an original song from my hometown called 111 Crestmont Road. It was the house I grew up in. The house where the stairs creaked, where you could almost feel the ghost in the air. It was one of those magical wooden houses.
That was about his early life and early friends and the things that kind of gave him some inspiration as a writer and a general human being, I think, really.
Glenn even switched some of my words around, which I allowed him to do.
That was a great process and really great working with Glenn on that song.
And then they also did my song that I wrote for Paul McCartney and Brian Wilson, A Friend Like You. Paul McCartney is from UK, as you guys, everyone knows.
I'd always liked that song from Getting Over My Head, which had come out fairly recently, but I really liked it.
Steve Wrigley and Glenn Richardson did an arrangement of that and a beautiful arrangement on this album.
We wanted to change the feel a little bit and make it a bit more soulful, maybe. So we sat down and wrote a kind of Ray Charles-y version of it. And he was really crazy about it, loved it, absolutely loved it.
You inspire me.
Of salt water. Then I met a 19-year-old then, Paul Steele. He had a deal with Polydor, and we started working together.
Paul Steele, who's a local Brighton musician, did a piece of music with Stevie called Ocean, which is a really beautiful piece of work.
My favorite song on the album, California Feelings, is Ocean.
He read the poem to me, showed me all the lyrics, and we literally sat down on the piano, came up with a melody, came up with lyrics for it immediately. And I thought, well, seeing as you're here, it'd be great if you could do a spoken word part for the song.
Paul said, why don't you just put some more stuff at the beginning? And Stevie said, well, I haven't got anything. He said, well, just do it. And he just did it on the spot, you know. And he's really good at that. He's very in the moment, Stevie.
You know, I just left the mic in the room and he just kept going for it. And that made up most of the spoken word portion of the song.
Before any manifestation, after all has risen and falls again, is the forever smile. Inspiration is for mortals.
It's beautiful. I think that it captures who he is and what he does really well in that one song.
So it's very exciting. It was a new experience for me, definitely.
David Courtney, who I had a hit with, I think in the 70s, with Odyssey in England, especially, it also was a dance song called Magic Touch. He and I started working together again, too.
We've got a song on there together that we wrote called Star Cries, which is part of a trilogy that we wrote about 2 years ago when Steve was here in Brighton.
Star Cries, beyond the rings of Saturn. Bands of the universe, there is a place beyond space, beyond time, and it's in your mind.
The track, the actual backing track of Star Cries, was taken from a track from a very early album of mine, which David Gilmour plays on. So we used the backing track of that, and then Stevie wrote the poem of Star Cries, which we put over the top of it. And the blend really worked really well.
So Child of Winter to me relates to all the fun that I had in Brighton, and the Fringe Festival reminds me of Christmas. Now that's me. If I sound out there, it may sound out there. I find summer very close to Christmas in my consciousness. And Brighton somehow, I think I felt I was at Christmas time, even in the summer. I can't explain it. So that song has a lot of joy in it. When Brian and I originally wrote it, the Beach Boy version never got much promotion, but this one is full of fun, and Rachel and the reindeers and all the people that were involved in doing the video. What an incredibly fun experience. I got more comments from not singing than anything I sang. It's funny, on that album I got more comments from the video than some of the things I spoke and sang. And I didn't say a word except I went around acting like a lunatic or having fun. This captured the spirit that Brian and I want to capture of Christmas. I just love it. It's a fun, lighthearted, it's not a heavy song. And I think it has the joy of life that can be really innocent and beautiful.
Stevie's follow-up project is Yo Mama, a collaboration with John Tyven, who also appeared on California Feeling. Their new album has already won critics over, and maybe more collaborations with Brighton artists will follow down the line. Stevie has discovered in himself an ability to express life's hidden truths in a way that touches our hearts and minds. It is a unique talent which enriches and inspires all who hear him.
Wake up every morning, being grateful to be alive. Don't always try and be the one to talk. Listen. Listen to what you're feeling and hearing inside yourself. Listen to what others say. Listen to the sounds all around you. And listen to no sound. The voice of inspiration comes into us when we open up to it and are receptive. The words are there. We pull them out of the air into our thoughts. We lay them on the paper like rolling dice. Now, how do you succeed as a being? My belief, the way you succeed is to express generosity of spirit.